We are at the home stretch of the Dream Season Football League and begin our Week 8 highlights with one of the great rivalries in professional sports. And the loser is eliminated from the playoffs. From the link, the 2-5 Eagles play host to the 2-5 Giants. And Malcolm Jenkins begins the game with an interception of Eli Manning. That would be a common theme of the Giants offense today. Jake Elliott, the rookie kicker from Memphis, hits 3 field goals for Philadelphia. And the Eagles lead in the fourth quarter 9-0. And by way of that defense, as mentioned, they sack Eli Manning 6 times in the game. Timmy Jernigan finds Eli Manning in the end zone for a Philadelphia safety. The Giants gain 4 yards passing and are shut down by that Eagles defense. New York is done. At 2-6, their playoff hopes are over. Meanwhile, Philadelphia next week plays at the Rams with their season on the line. The Eagles are 3-5. Fresh off the Bears' first win of the season against the Eagles, Chicago at 1-6 plays host to the 5-2 Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Both defenses had an incredible game, but with 1:10 to go in the fourth quarter, Martin Gramatica, who is kicking 93% on field goals this year, gives the Buccaneers the late lead, and Rex Grossman, who completed only 7 passes for the game, is sacked by Alshon and Singleton. The Buccaneers have clinched the playoffs with a 6-2 start to the season. The 2006 Colts are in the midst of an incredible comeback this year. After an 0-4 start, the Colts win their 4th game in a row, 9-3 over the Ravens. Baltimore settles for this field goal, and the Colts gain over 100 yards rushing for the 4th straight week with this third down carry by Joseph Addai. The Colts make the playoffs if they beat the Raiders in Oakland next week. Meanwhile, the 3-5 Ravens are playing for their postseason lives against the Jaguars in Week 9. Well, as mentioned, Peyton Manning's Colts went 0-4 to begin the year. Peyton Manning's Broncos started 0-5. But they have now won 2 of their last 3 games as the Bronco quarterback tosses 2 touchdowns to tight end Julius Thomas and a shutout win over the 0-8 Jets. Denver must beat the Patriots in Foxborough or they are eliminated from the postseason. They also host Peyton Manning's Colts in Week 10. Carolina is almost unbeatable this year at home at 3-1. The Panthers come in at 4-3 overall against the struggling Rams. Jericho Cotchery ties the game with an incredible catch and run. And the Rams, for all of the big plays they have made this year, Kuechly forced a fumble. If it weren't for their 9 turnovers, they would probably have a winning record this season. And Kuechly recovers. The tight end from Washington just gets crushed by Luke Kuechly. 14-10 Carolina, but Holt reels in this 51-yard go-ahead touchdown, and the Rams take the late lead against the Panthers bunch that was 0-6 on third down. This is a 1st-and-10 throw picked off by the diving Aeneas Williams. A booth review is needed to make sure that this play was legal. Yes, it was. Dre Bly tips, and Williams recovers on the diving interception. This Wilkins field goal of 53 yards officially wins the game, and now the 3-5 Rams have a shot to beat the Eagles and make the playoffs next week in L.A. Meanwhile, the Panthers visit the Saints in Week 9. 2002 Raiders are 4-3 and visit the 0-5 Steelers, who have 5 losses already, 2 more, and their hopes of a playoff bid are eliminated. Jerry Rice reels in his first touchdown of the year. Raiders lead 13-7 at the half. Rod Woodson forces a fumble of Heath Miller, scoops it up and scores. And the Raiders have taken a 20-7 lead as the Pro Bowler from Purdue garners Player of the Week honors for the defense with that sort of effort of Heath Miller, the rookie. In the fourth quarter, Roethlisberger guides a comeback try, but Jeff Reed misses his 3rd field goal of the year, and that is inches away from just on the inside of the uprights. And the Raiders win the game and are playoff bound at 5-3. Steelers host the Chargers next week. Speaking of those Chargers, San Diego visits rainy Jacksonville in a near scoreless first half. Meanwhile, the 5-2 Jaguar defense gives up an 88-yard touchdown throw from Phillip Rivers to Vincent Jackson. Rivers has tossed for a league-high 11 touchdowns this season. Then the first catch of the year is another touchdown. This is the Malcolm Floyd of San Diego. And late in the fourth quarter, the Jaguars lean on the services of Leonard Fournette. Back-to-back throws of the rookie. First gains 10, the second picks up 22 to push the Jaguars in the red zone. And Bortles, on third and inches, fires a touchdown to the rookie off play action. That is Keelan Cole, the product out of Kentucky at Wesleyan at all places. Jaguars lead by three late in regulation. But on first and 10, Rivers comes out firing, with San Diego's offense having their best game of the season against this defense. Rivers and company gain 418 yards. And Rivers finds Eric Parker, a top four receiver in the league, which sets up the game-tying field goal. We are headed for overtime. The Jaguars punt, and then the Chargers punt on an incompletion on third down to Gates. The Jaguars punt again. Jacksonville has negative 1 yard in overtime. The Chargers on their second OT drive convert with a second down throw to Michael Turner, his 29th catch of the season, by far and away his best, as the Chargers set up the field goal from Kading, and the Pro Bowler wins the game. San Diego is in the playoffs as the sixth seed with a 4-4 record. Chargers visit Pittsburgh next week. Tom Brady's 7-0 Patriots visit Patrick Mahomes' 6-1 Chiefs in what was billed as the game of the week, and it was an absolute letdown. This wasn't even close to what we anticipated as a rivalry coming in. Maybe these two teams meet again in the playoffs. New England rolls the Chiefs defense, scoring on three consecutive drives to begin the game, and takes a monster three-score lead. Mahomes is sacked here by Brown. The Chiefs waited until the third quarter to gain their opening first down. Brady was 17 of 20 for 230 yards and that touchdown to Watson. Kareem Hunt in the fourth quarter loses a fumble forced by Rodney Harrison. The Patriots safety jars it away from Hunt, who has lost two fumbles this season. And the Patriots cash in with this touchdown run, fifth of the year, to lead the league for Lawrence Maroney. Brady has been sensational, and the Patriots clinch the AFC with a 24-10 road win over Kansas City. This game was yet another letdown for Week 8, as from the Georgia Dome, the 4-3 Falcons play host to the 5-2 Saints. Ryan evades pressure and delivers a third down conversion, one of seven in a row for the Atlanta offense. That was to Julio Jones. And Aldrick Robinson makes a leaping catch in the end zone. That's the first of three touchdown throws in the game from Matty Ice. Second to Jones, and the third to Jacob Tammet. The Falcons dismantle the Saints 28-7 at home, and both teams are now 5-3 this year. What a performance for the Falcons offense. The Seahawks and the Packers in a showdown between the top two seeds in the NFC matched up in a game from Lambeau, which came down to the final possession. What a game this was between two juggernauts in the conference. One of two fourth down conversions for the Packers offense in the game was a pass completion to Jordy Nelson, but the Packers offense stalls in the red zone. They have struggled most of the season converting red zone trips to touchdowns this year. They're about 18th in the league in doing that, so the game is tied at three in the fourth quarter. Third down throw from Rodgers is out of the hands of Jermichael Finley. That would prove to be a pivotal play late in the game, because Russell Wilson and the Seahawks convert a third and 10 with the only pass completion of the game to tight end Zach Miller out of Arizona State for a 28-yard game. Then Marshawn Lynch picks up 10 here. Beast mode in the fourth quarter games in 2013 was almost unstoppable. Then on second and goal, Wilson finds Jermaine Kearse. The wide receiver from Washington scores his first touchdown of the year. Seahawks lead 10-3 with under 2 minutes to go, but Rodgers guides a comeback. Rodgers flips this pass to the tight end, but on fourth and 12, the Seahawks are set to have this game won. Hit as he throws, Rodgers throws incomplete. Pass interference against the excellent Brandon Browner gives the Packers a fresh set of downs. Third and 10, Rodgers is denied. Final play of regulation. Fourth and 10, Rodgers goes for it again, and this time, the linebacker in K.J. Wright makes the play, holding penalty on the Packers, and Green Bay has lost their second game in a row. The Seahawks defense is the best in football, giving up only 8 points per game. Let's take a look at the standings after Week 8 of the year. The Patriots have clinched the AFC. The Seahawks can clinch the NFC with a win over the Buccaneers next week. Rivers, Warner, and Woodson were all players of the week for Week 8 of the year, and Week 9 should be a thrilling set of games, and it begins with the top two seeds in the conference. We meet in Tampa Bay Also, the Broncos play the Patriots in Foxborough. This is Charger Dude 95.